Not because, you know, this is the first time that it's gonna happen. You know, but because this is a higher development. It's a higher level of struggle for our people. It couldn't have come on the, you know, on any other day than today. In the face of G8 and NATO. You know, this is our act of defiance. Our coming here together as youth and students of our people. It's a sign and an act of defiance in the face of imperialism. And we owe this to our brothers and sisters who have suffered and have sacrificed their lives for our people.
We've got to fight on a world basis, and we've got to know that the enemy is imperialism, and that the power of the banks and corporations comes from plundering the entire world.
My dear America, all I was ever told were the lies about you. I was told land of the free and home of the brave, but America, you never told me your cities were built on the blood of the indigenous and the bones of the slaves. Tall steel towers built over their graves, and when two planes came and knocked them out of the sky, America, you looked at me and asked why.
Since 1948, the Palestinian people have been fighting against settler colonialism that has a symbiotic relationship with and is an extension of U.S. neocolonialism in the Philippines, which wreaks havoc upon the lives and the land of the Filipino people and other oppressed peoples throughout the global south. The fundamental principles on which we fight is the liberation of our land and peoples.
Fight for legalization, right? But we're one of them, many organizations like yourself, that we see that the cause of mass migration, of poverty, famine, repression, and war is caused by U.S. imperialism and NATO.
Within the people, that there will be contradictions. Let's be realistic about this. We're going to have contradictions amongst each other. And it's and the ruling class exploits that. They use racism. They use these other tools to exploit that. We must come in as realists, acknowledging that we will have differences. We will have contradictions. However, the Black Panther Party said, differences amongst the people. Differences amongst the people are reconcilable. However, the difference between the people and the state are irreconcilable. Power to the people.
In the end, I guess it comes down to constantly having to ask ourselves as artists the question, who does our art serve? Which class does it serve? The ruling class, the 1%, or the working and oppressed classes, the 99%? So we invite you, artists and cultural workers, to help us build an international alliance of progressive artists and cultural workers. The challenge is launched. So I ask you, film the struggle, serve the people. Write, sing, dance, and paint the struggle. Serve the people. Artists, get out there to shape the struggle and serve the people.
Not that pop culture is bad, but we're up against like a lot of consumerist propaganda, a lot of like imperialist propaganda. So our cultural work needs to be really strong to be able to combat that and to be just as broad and just as beautiful and eye-catching to the masses, to everybody.
We cannot just talk about, you know, the struggle and the society that we're building in, you know, in cold statistical or like mechanical things. We also need to paint the beautiful picture of the society that we're building and the struggles of our people, so that, you know, it can unleash, you know, and capture the imaginations and the passion of the people, the particularly of the oppressed that we're, you know, aiming to change or to mobilize.
Ourselves, all we're conscious and all that, you know, conscious hip hop and all that underground backpack rap. You know, I don't say it, you know, like we shouldn't be saying that. We should be open and learning from other people, but at the same time, analyzing and seeing how we can change, you know, this system of, you know, like the hip hop world. Like it's fucked up. Like hip hop is really like profit now.
So-called the land of the trees. By the time we immigrate, there ain't nothing to eat. Cockle spin politicians never know reality. We the ones work the world and keep using.
I think that LFS has been consistent is learning the revolutionary songs from the Philippines.
When we do the songs, it's sort of like it's hearkening back to our roots, where we came from, and it's a way for us to, you know, really connect, you know, with the Filipino people, like in the Philippines and other compatriots who were forced to migrate to the United States. And so, you know, even though there might be like this cultural barrier or like you know, this vast distance between us, even though we're like oceans apart and there's like a language barrier, when we sing these songs, it's a way of like, you know, connecting with those.
Pokemon, if I'm talking evolution, you watching Jersey Shore, I'm screaming revolution.
For me, I actually got more into knowing my own history because of cultural work when I was in this black box theater in San Francisco called Bindle Stiff. And from there, I wanted to know more about my parents' languages. When growing up in the U.S., I was ashamed of being a Filipino, ashamed of my parents not knowing English very well. And then I realized that, you know, it's It's because of this system that demoralizes, that devalues who we are. And now I've come to realize that we should be proud in who we are, in our culture, and we have to reclaim our culture that is more pro-people, that is for peace and freedom.
Justice!
How we gonna get it?
People power!
How we gonna get it?
I think the role of cultural work is to take the information that we learn, which is, you know, really deep and might be overwhelming, and to put it into a form that is digestible artistically. In my case, I'm a rapper, so I take the stuff we learn about the Philippines and then translate that into a rap song. That not just to translate to people that listen to it, but even to translate it for myself.
Hip-hop has been used as a tool to educate, but I also really see it as an agitating force in our movement.
I do my best to live my life right and do no harm, but contest to defend their rights, I will take up arms so that my daughter can one day live in abundance and peace. I'll put that bullet in the belly, till the blood of this beast. Resistance is our legacy. If you believe, you can bring it, you can sing it at home or in the street.
It's not just something, you know, that we do to inspire like broad masses, but also to keep each other inspired and keep each other working.
Cultural work is tied to building revolution, because revolution is not just a change of one aspect of society or one aspect of our lives. You know, it needs to change comprehensively, radically, you know, all aspects of life, from the economic base of society up to the mental, the behavior and the, you know, the attitude of the people.
The great leap forward, we stepping in. Who's next on the mic to rip? I got that gift, the blessing, it is time to trip. Back to the KRCC, back to Frisco at the FCC, back to New York at the Field Forum. AB, he just made me cry, like maybe. Let's go.
I never
left. Oh, let's go.
Come for a new grand world. Let's get together in an international league.